It's originally called Einladung an die Waghalsigen and translated as Invitation to the Bold of Heart. And it's a story about two sisters. They grow up in a deserted mining town where fire has been burning in the tunnels underground for many, many years. And there's no solution how to deal with the fire. It just keeps on burning and spreading. And so people are forced to leave this place. It's become a very dangerous place to be in. And the two sisters were born after this fire started burning, so they have no recollection of what the town used to be like. They set out and to find out what happened, what the solution could be to this problem, and to find also their own history. Well, I first read about a town where this had actually happened in the United States. There is a town called Centralia where a fire has been burning since the 60s and it's deserted now, people left. And I was very interested in this atmosphere. I saw pictures of the town, how it looked before and what it looks like now. And I felt like the way this place appeared was really evoked some emotions and thoughts that I had already carried around with me and was thinking about society, the end, the so-called end of history, just questions I had about what's happening around me. Yes, it's hard to wrap it up in a short summary, but I think I was born in 85, so I basically was born after the wall came down, and the way I perceived the present, I was always being told all alternatives failed, so this is the way it will be forever, deal with it, capitalism, that's the way it works, and there's no other possibility. And at the same time, I felt that in Switzerland, where I grew up, it is a very, very rich country, and still there are people who are very poor. And I just, those were questions, for example, I had. How can it be that in such a rich country there are poor people? And then, of course, also not only on a national level, but international, how it's a very strange feeling of, by accident, being born into such a rich country. And at the same time, there are places where it is very different. Of course, there's something of myself in them, but I like the characters to be very artificial in a way that I like them to just be like speakers, or I don't think a lot about their emotions and their psychology. And at first there was only one character, one young woman, and she was always writing and doing research and sitting at her desk like me, and I got to a point where I was very desperate because I thought, oh no, she needs to go out and see the world and take action and be active. So I kind of split her up into two, and then there's one that's still reading and writing, and the other one is outside and does research. They are the narrators, but there's not the, I wouldn't call it a story. It's more that they are writing down notes and quotes and everything they find, so it's more of a collection of, it's a fact book, but not with only facts, with findings, ideas, excerpts from books. It's a collection of, it's some kind of alternative map of the place they live in. It doesn't have a very strong plot. To me, it's more of a thing about association and the relation between the fragments. I'm afraid I don't have an answer. This was an issue when the book was published in Germany, because many publishers want to write novel on the cover because they know that it sells better. They are a little bit afraid of short stories, for example, and I didn't feel that it was a novel. But then I felt like it was not important enough to fight about this little word. So it says novel on the cover. But then at readings, people kept asking me, do you really think this is a novel? And I don't know. I like to call it a collection of text, but that's not a real genre. I think it was conscious, and it was also just myself failing at. I look at it like many attempts at beginning to write the story, maybe, or to find a point where to start from, and then I failed again and I started again. And I also like the white space between, and I think it's important. That's what I like about poetry. I often feel when I read novels that it doesn't give me enough room to think for myself and to go out in all directions in my mind. So it was a very conscious decision. I didn't plan on being a writer, but I knew I wanted to write. So when the book was published and it was kind of well received, I all of a sudden felt like I was officially a writer now, and I'm still trying to figure out what that means and what it means for my writing. But I'm happy that right now I'm able to write and to travel, like coming to India, for example, and somehow make it work with the money too. That's a big issue, of course, and I don't know what it will be like in the future. I would like to continue writing, and I'm working on a second book. It also doesn't work with a plot, but it's different in the sense that it tries to create a space where many things happen at the same time, which is of course impossible because text is always linear. But I'm trying to get rid of, because it deals with boundaries, national boundaries and borders, so I'm trying to get rid of those in the text and make it one big space. Well, it's hard to say something about the general state. There are some exciting things happening and also some things that I don't pay that much attention to, but I think I wouldn't make the difference between age that much. I don't think there's one generation, a young generation. There's more certain people that I think do very, very interesting work, and it doesn't really depend on age that much.